What's up, guys? It's the Fighting Therapist here, and we're here with episode 3. The talk is going to be, which is the best split? So before we start the video, guys, please give me a thumbs up, give me a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you guys do know when these videos come out. As well, don't forget down below in the first link called Giveaways is my newsletter. So you guys are going to get first come, first serve to all the free content that I'm giving on YouTube. You guys are going to get it a month in advance with some special deals that I don't really put on these videos. So if you want that, pretty much go sign up. Newsletter comes out to you guys 3 times a week. Free content, free info. Go enjoy that. Let's jump into it right now. Which split is best? It depends. Now, I know that's like a very iffy answer, but it's gonna depend on a couple of things. How many times a week can you allocate to training is gonna be one, right? That's gonna help follow a split that you want. What are your goals? Maintenance, hypertrophy, growth, power, strength. What is your goal? Are you an athlete? Are you a weekend warrior? Or are you just a person that wants to be healthy? Are you a newbie in the gym? Are you an intermediate? Are you advanced? And the last one is, do you have a competition coming up? You don't need to be an athlete for this, but do you have something that's coming up? All of those are gonna depend, are gonna help you decide which split is best for you. Now I'm gonna put an example here, and I'm gonna use me as a case, and I'm gonna use somebody else as, let's say I'm A, this is B. So I'm A, the athlete. I have competitions. I need to train roughly 2 to 3 times a day. So if I follow, let's say a typical push-pull leg split, right? That's gonna get me in the gym about 6 times a week, right? I'm gonna be hitting each body part twice. And the volume per session, if you remember from the last video, as the weeks go by, it's gonna be pretty high. So when it comes to soreness, I'm gonna be pretty sore. So if I'm an MMA fighter, jiu-jitsu athlete, wrestler, and I'm gonna put that much volume in the gym for training, and then come here and have to wrestle and punch and kick, it's not gonna go well, and I might risk injury later on, which is just gonna put me down and not be able to compete in the competition that I need to compete for. Now, I'm not saying that's a bad split, but let's say I was an MMA fighter, jiu-jitsu, whatever, athlete, and I down-regulated the amount of jiu-jitsu, wrestling, or MMA I was doing, and I had more time because it's my off-season to be in the gym, then I would follow a push-pull split legs workout. And I have done that in the past because it was my off season. So I was maybe only doing technique 2-3 times a week and it wasn't that intense. So I can afford to go in the gym and really push it and be sore. Now that I'm kind of in between sessions, so I'm coming off an off season and I'm coming into another one, I tend to follow more of a full body split. The reason I do that, I'm able to get more frequency within the week. So I'm hitting each body part 5 times a week because I'm doing a 5-day split. The volume is still gonna be the same, but it's gonna be distributed within those 5 days. So I'm not gonna be in the gym doing 4 to 6 different pushing exercises. I'm only gonna do 1, maybe 2 as an accessory for that day. The intensity is still gonna be high. I'm not gonna be as sore. So let's say, for example, if I was doing squats, that day all I had to do was squats. Maybe I have to do some calf raises later and some hamstring curls, but I'm never gonna be super sore as if I was doing a leg day, where I would probably do squats, deadlift, walking lunges, glute bridges, glute kickbacks. I'm gonna be pretty tired as the workout goes on. So when it comes to me pushing the intensity with a push-pull leg split, you pretty much have to down-regulate the intensity with the exercises. But as I'm doing a full day split, I don't need to do that. I'm really able to give it all I can for that one exercise, for that one muscle group. And then when I'm done later on, I'm not that sore, right? Again, when you first start a new cycle, you will get sore within the first week or two, but later your body will sensitize to that and you will adapt. But in the beginning, my goal as a fighter, so I can be able to come here and train hard, is to not be sore. So I could come here and push it and do everything I want, while at the same time gaining my hypertrophy that I want right now, because that is my goal, hypertrophy and strength. So that's what I'm working on. Now, when it comes to if you're like a newbie or not, it really doesn't matter. So push-pull leg split, personally, I think push-pull legs, full body, or just a push-pull split, it doesn't honestly matter. It's what you can allocate your time for. So again, I'm using my option B here. I got my cameraman in the back, Daniel. Right now, he's following a full body split. Daniel has done push-pull legs before. He has done push-pull before, and now he's doing full body. Because now Daniel has his business to work on. He has goals that he wants to do, which comes to hypertrophy and strength. He rock climbs roughly 1 to 2 times a week. He has school and he needs to study. So all that factors, he can give himself 4 days. So he would either do a push-pull, let's say, right, because he has 4 days in a week, or he does a full body. He's able to stimulate his muscle more with more frequency. He's able to distribute the volume throughout the week so that he's able to do his other activities that he likes and that he enjoys to do. And he doesn't get stuck in the gym for about 3-4 hours because of all those long workouts. So what split is best? It really depends on the individual. It's individualized for what works for you. I don't think there's a superior one. Again, if you're an advanced lifter and you're at the peak, then maybe structuring little things is gonna make more of a change. But when it comes to just the average day person and an athlete, you really wanna take those two perspectives and what you can do and what you are doing to choose what split is best for you. So that's it for that video, guys. Super simple, super easy. Nothing else. Stay tuned for episode 4, which is going to be coming next. That's it for this video. Punch, headbutt, elbow, knee.